studio microphone's easy mode is simple to use, but with simplicity there is also less control. As you need more, or if you find the easy settings are not exactly the way you want, you may want to progress to Pro mode. There are a lot more settings in Pro mode, and it intimidates some people, but it's really not too hard. In this video, I'll walk through switching to Pro, tuning your settings to suit your environment and preferences, and making a recording. There will also be some general tips on improving your audio quality to help you make great recordings. First of all, some people think Pro mode is going to cost money, but it just has Pro-level features and is still completely free. For this tutorial, you will need headphones, and they really should be wired headphones. Bluetooth headphones have a long delay and are not good for live monitoring. Up on the top app bar, tap the kebab menu and choose Settings. Select User Level and choose Pro mode. We'll also enable the preamplifier filter because we'll use it later, and go back to the main app screen. At this point, if your headphones aren't plugged in, plug them in now. One of the great features of Pro mode is that even though you have headphones plugged in, you don't have to use the microphone in the headphones. In fact, usually you don't want to. The microphone on the phone is usually much more sensitive. Because you plugged in the headphones, that will currently be the default input, but we can change that by going into the input settings. Here, you should select the built-in microphone on your phone instead. Some phones have more than one microphone, as you can see here. You can try them all and see which one works better for you. We're going to tune our settings, and for that it's useful to listen to your microphone live. So go to Output and choose the wired headset. To begin with, we'll turn off all of the filters. Now we can start the recording. It's not recording to a file, so there is no hurry. Just take your time and experiment. At this point, if you talk, you should immediately hear yourself in the headphones. Don't worry if it doesn't sound very good. We'll improve that as we go through. First of all, let's figure out where the microphone on our phone actually is. I selected bottom microphone, so that's a hint, but there are so many holes on a phone, I'm not exactly sure which is the microphone. I can just rub my fingertip over the phone, and when I get to the microphone, it will suddenly make a lot more noise. So for me, the microphone is here. These microphones are a little bit directional. For the best recording, it should point in the direction of your face. That way, it will be more sensitive to your voice and pick up less background noise. Here, I'm recording in a room with some background noise to help demonstrate the effects of the filters. We'll use the background noise reduction filter soon to improve it. But the less you rely on filters to correct bad sound and instead improve the audio fundamentals of your recording, the better your final result will be. Rather than a noisy room like this, the very first thing you should try to do is find a nice quiet location to record. Turn off air conditioners and fans and anything else that makes noise while you record. A professional studio uses acoustic panels to prevent echoes, but they're quite expensive. A good place to start is just find a suitable room. Ideally, you want a room without lots of bare walls because they echo a lot. A carpeted room or a room with rugs is better than hard floors. A room with lots of curtains and other clutter on the walls, like shelves or decorations, can all help to reduce echo without spending anything. If the room is too small, the echo may also be more obvious. Okay, now that you've found the best place with the least noise and echo, we can use the app features to improve it even further. For example, we'll use the noise reduction filter. For that to work most effectively, we want the audio at a good level, so let's talk about that first. Let's look at the preamplifier settings. The preamplifier is used to change the microphone volume before it goes to any of the other filters. We'll just talk about gain for now. A gain factor of 1.0 means that the input will be unchanged. First, enable the filter with the switch at the top. Hold your phone out at arm's length and talk. It will probably be quite quiet, like this. Hello, this is a test. Turn up the gain while talking or singing until the meter fills with green but doesn't go up into yellow or red. If it's sometimes yellow or red, turn it down a little. You can hear the voice much better now, but also the background sounds are very obvious. Now instead, bring the microphone right up to your mouth and talk.
Test, test.
It's very loud and clipping in the red, so adjust the gain down again until you get consistent green bars only, with no yellow or red appearing. If in doubt, set it a little bit lower. It won't matter if it's slightly low, but it causes a bigger problem if it's too high because it will become distorted. You have the same result in both. A voice at the correct level, but with the microphone closer to you, you don't need as much amplification, so the background noise and room echo is relatively much quieter. The voice also sounds richer and deeper. This is the importance of correct microphone placement. But you can be too close as well. There are two sounds in particular that cause problems in recording. The plosives, like the letter P, as in Peter prefers poetry, p-p-p, and sibilants, in particular the letter S, as in seashells, seashells, s-s-s-s. Professional studios usually have a pop filter that helps to reduce the thudding sounds that comes from air blowing over the microphone. There are some things you can do to improvise your own pop filter, but even without one, there are some things you can do. The most important one is to put the microphone slightly off to the side and above or below your mouth so that the wind coming out of your mouth doesn't directly hit the microphone. Aim the microphone direction directly towards your larynx and your throat instead of your mouth, and that will help to reduce the S sounds. A good guide for distance is for the microphone to be about 2 fist widths away from your mouth. But you might find a little less works even better. Just test for the popping and essing. Now you have the perfect location for holding your microphone. We have another video on improving this studio setup more, but this will do for now. Adjust the preamplifier gain for this new location, making sure when you talk or sing at the maximum volume you plan to use, that it fills and stays in the green. Let's go back to the main screen and look at the background noise reduction settings. There are several methods of noise reduction available. We are going to use the deep learning noise reduction here, although if you're recording singing rather than speech, you might want to use the spectral noise reduction. There is a separate video on using that. Make sure deep learning noise reduction is selected. If you see a yellow warning like this, then your phone may be too old and slow to properly run the noise reduction. You can still try, but it might cut in and out or be distorted. If your phone is too slow, you can probably still use the spectral noise reduction. See the other video on that. Switch the filter on. Suddenly, all the background noise is gone. Between speech is just silence. Back on the main screen, you can see the noise reduction is switched on. We can switch it on and off directly from here too. Turn it off now, and let's look at how reverb can help with noise too. This is mainly only useful for singers though. Open the reverb screen. It looks overwhelming, and there is a lot of control, but for now, just use a preset. Choose Karaoke 1. This is a fairly gentle reverb that is like what most karaoke machines use. Turn it on. Test, test. You will hear that the background noise is also suddenly smoothed out and reduced. If you talk or sing, you will hear a slight echo, which singers often use to cover up minor singing defects and make it sound better. It's not appropriate for everything, but for many people it is useful. Obviously, you can also use pitch auto-tuning to improve singing too, but that is for another video. Okay, let's go back. We'll turn off reverb and look at the equalizer, which is the second tab. By default, this is flat, but if you're recording singing or speech, then you can quieten some of the really low and high-pitched noises, which can also help. Try switching to the speech preset, and you will hear some of the background noise drop away. It can also help to prevent some of the booming bass sound of a very close microphone. So adjust to your preferences and your pitch. If in doubt, or if you notice any distortion, you can just keep it flat. Let's go back and turn on noise reduction again. Just the preamplifier and noise reduction we have here, along with our microphone positioning, is enough to make a pretty good recording. That's all I did to make this recording. Dynamic range compression and normalization may also be useful for you to improve quality, but we'll cover that in a separate video. Press stop and change the output to local media file. Now press start, talk, sing, or whatever. Hello, this is an example recording. Afterwards, press stop. Go to the library, which is the last tab at the bottom. Select your recording and press play to hear your recording. Hello, this is an example recording. That's basic studio tuning and pro mode in a nutshell. There is a lot more you can do, which will be covered in other videos. See ya.